Hi friends, this is Hari Naganand, Ed Moody. Now I am going to dictate a passage at 110 words per minute. We have an app of this channel available as Shorthand Hub in Play Store, and the link relating to our channel is in the description box. 5 seconds left. Start. No doubt, when the petitioner raised a specific plea as to the territorial jurisdiction in the counter filed in IA number 928 of 2011, filed under Order 1, Rule 10, CPC, the court is not supposed to decide such an issue of territorial jurisdiction. The scope of Order 1, Rule 10, Class 2 CPC is limited, and at best, the court is required to decide whether the proposed party is necessary or proper party in whose absence the suit can't be adjudicated finally and effectually, or whether the suit can be decided completely though no relief is claimed against such party. The jurisdiction of the court under Order 1, Rule 10 CPC is limited, but in view of specific plea raised for want of territorial jurisdiction of the senior civil judge, the senior civil judge incidentally recording a finding regarding territorial jurisdiction, and such finding would not operate as res judicata though it is attained finality, since it was not an issue before the court in a petition filed under Order 1, Rule 10 CPC. Section 11 of CPC deals with principles of res judicata, which is based off a public policy to put an end to the litigation at one stage or the other. When a petition under Order 1, Rule 10, Class 2 CPC is filed to implead, but instead of confining its decision under Order 1, Rule 10, Class 2 CPC, the trial court, exceeding the scope of inquiry of Order 1, Rule 10, CPC, recorded a finding that the senior civil judge vested with the jurisdiction to try the suit in respect of B schedule property also. Order 14, Class 1, CPC deals with the issues. According to it, issues are two types: issue of fact and issue of law. The question of framing issue would arise when the material proposition of law or fact is affirmed by one party and denied by the other party. The material propositions are those propositions of law or fact which the plaintiff must allege in order to constitute his defense. Therefore, each material proposition affirmed by one party and denied by the other shall form the subject of distinct issues, either issue of fact or issue of law. Framing of an issue under Order 14, Rule 1 CPC, the court has to frame issue confining the pleadings depending upon the nature of the dispute before the court. No issue of fact or law can be framed unless such proposition of fact or law is affirmed by one party and denied by the other. Here the petitioner, being the respondent, filed a petition under Order 1, Rule 10 CPC, asserted that the senior civil judge lacks territorial jurisdiction, but there was no denial. In such a case, the senior civil judge is not supposed to record a finding, but committed an error exceeding its power in recording such finding in a petition filed under Order 1, Rule 10, CPC. Therefore, such finding as to the jurisdiction which is into the subject matter in a petition filed under Order 1, Rule 10, CPC can't be said to be the finding based on the issue since it was not the issue framed before the court. In such circumstances, dismissal of the petition on the basis of such finding and scope of the suit, etc., alone can't be the ground to reject the relief claimed by the petitioner under Order 14, Rule 2, CPC. Though the counsel for the petitioner placed reliance on a judgment reported in Arjun Singh case referred supra, the legal proposition laid down therein is not in dispute. But when there was an issue and recorded a finding which attained finality on merits, it would certainly stop